Scientists have discovered a new insect that has more legs, penises, and friends than me. Great. Hey, creepy crawlers, Trace here for DNews. In late 2016, a tiny new insect was found in a cave deep within Sequoia National Park. This little guy was a millipede, but not one scientists had seen before. It came with 414 legs, no eyes, 200 poison glands, which secreted an unknown substance, and maybe most creepily, four penises. This multi-genital creature named Illacme tobini is evolutionarily related to a known millipede group called Illacme planipes, which actually has 750 legs, more than any animal on Earth. Yet our interest still lies with tobini and his many penes. They're located at the 9th and 10th pair of legs and actually serve a dual purpose as penises and legs. We're really working that third and fourth leg joke. These leg penises are called gonopods, and they're present on other millipede species as well. This isn't unique, although none of these other millipedes have more than two. They don't quite function in the same way as mammal penises do. They scoop sperm from another part of the body called the gonopore, and they use the gonopod to push it into the female millipede's cephalopods. Penises for legs? Being a diplopodologist is way cooler than I thought. What's more interesting is that millipedes aren't the only ones carrying multi-tools, if you will. The order of Squamata, which are scaled reptiles and includes all snakes and lizards, also have multiple penises, although again, not more than two each. In some cases, each individual penis has two tips, but that's more like four tips total. These two penises are called hemipenes, and fun fact, they're usually covered with spikes and hooks so they can attach securely when they get near a female. So why do these animals have so much to give, whereas us humans and most other penis-bearing animals have to live with their one and only? Well, a study published in the journal Nature from 2014 has an interesting evolutionary theory. See, the order Squamata and reptiles in general are marked by their amphibious nature. Hundreds of millions of years ago, their ancestors were ocean-dwelling, and eventually they sprouted legs and crawled onto the shore so they would get the best of both worlds. But that's a pretty tricky move. Things are different here on land than they are underwater. And one enormous difference is, of course, mating. See, it may be simplistic to say, but if you're mating in the water, you're really just squirting out as much as you can, hoping that the water carries it to the right place. And that tends to work pretty well. On land, though, indiscriminate spraying doesn't work too well. Everything sort of just falls to the ground. What this study in Nature found is that these double genitalia were based on the position of an orifice known as the cloaca. It's found in amphibians, reptiles, birds, and even some fish. As an animal develops, the cloaca signals nearby cells and tells them to become a penis. Since reptiles evolved separately, their cloaca is positioned differently for use underwater. Simply put, penises on reptiles are based on their hind leg positions. So whether you have one or two or four penises, baby, you were born this way. And this begs the question to me, why do we even have sex at all? Why don't we just breed asexually? Find out in this video. And let us know down in the comments if you have any other new species you want us to profile or science questions, and please subscribe for more DNews.